second video, if you might have seen there, so I have discussed about 24 satellites would be in the space area, and our GPS device will receive the signal from the 24 satellites. At any point of time, our GPS device will communicate with the 4 satellites, and we are getting GPS signal. So, how exactly this GPS device will work, and what are the GPS codes equipped in the our GPS receivers, and what are the bandwidth that satellites is sending to our GPS receivers? How many types of downlinks it will send, and what is the block diagram of GPS receiver? How GPS receiver will work also, I am going to discuss in this particular video. We can see the how satellite will send downlink streams, that is in L1, L2, and how we will dealing that particular signal, and we can display the particular place, height, time and speed. Okay, here we are going to discuss about these 3 things. Also, at last, we are going to discuss about block diagram of GPS receiver. This is very important. How GPS receiver will work. So, it will be equipped with the RF antenna and amplifiers and ADC converters and the DSP processor and the microcontroller and the display. So, using the display and microcontroller, we will display the calculated values on the GPS receiver screen or on the maps. Okay, thank you. Hi guys, so in previous session we have discussed about how GPS device will receive the signal from the satellites. As I am again repeating, there will be the 24 satellites in the space, and every time, at any time, our GPS device. In previous session we have discussed about how GPS device will get the signal from the satellites. As I am again repeating, we are using United States Navstar system. It has been equipped with the 24 satellites. So at any point of time, our GPS device will receive the signal from the 4 satellites. So GPS device will receive the signal at any time from the at least 4 satellites. So from the 4 satellites, using the trilation method, so it will cover particular area, and where 4 satellites area would be matched at particular point, we will take the less precise span, and our DSP processor will calculate a particular position and particular distance from the above mean sea level, that is height, and time will be synchronized from the atomic clocks of the satellites. So atomic clocks are monitored by the base stations, and speed will be determined by the DSP processors. So 4 matters will be presented. So how GPS device will equip, and what is the block diagram of the GPS device, how GPS device will work, we are going to discuss here. So in the GPS device, so we have GPS codes and we have GPS services and we have GPS block diagram. We have GPS block diagram. In the GPS course, so we have 2 types of course. Course acquisition code. Course acquisition code and precise location. Precise location. So in the course acquisition, it will be used for the civilian purpose, and precise location will be used for the military purpose. So course acquisition will downlink with 1 Mbps, 1.02 Mbps, and precise location will downlink the signal, that is, this is the L1, and precise location will downlink the signal with 10.23 Mbps. As precise location will send with the more bandwidth, our location will be very precise. up to 3 meters or 5 meters. So in the 1.2 Mbps it will be up to 100 meters. It will be up to 3 to 5 meters. In the coarse acquisition, so our satellite will send the code two types. This will be the satellite. When it is downlinking, it is sending in the L1 and L2 bands. So L1 will be downlinked by the coarse acquisition GPS receivers and L2 will be downlinked by the precise locations. This is the GPS coarse which is sending by the satellites and GPS services. There are two types of services, that is for general public services and precise location services. In the general public services, only we can decrypt the L1 signal. Only we can decrypt the L1 signal. In the precise location, we can decrypt the L1 and L2 signals both. So to decrypt the L2 signal, we have to install or we have to encrypt the Y code signal in the GPS receiver. So if we have already Y code equipped in the particular device, then only it can encrypt the L2 signal which is used for the military purpose. And all general public GPS device will encrypt the L1 signal only. And remaining is about GPS block diagram. So how GPS block diagram would work? So this is the GPS, let us say this would be the GPS block diagram. So let us say we are getting signal from the satellite. So as I said, there will be two streams, L1 and L2. As ours is a general public GPS receiver, so we are decrypting only L2. If it is used for the military purpose, we can also decrypt the L2 signal also. What is this? This is the GPS receiver. This is transmitter and it does not require any data connection. It is only receiving the signal from the satellite. So first, the signal which is received by the satellite would be the RF signal. RF signal receiver. So this would be the antenna. Usually a circularly polarized antenna. Usually it is a circularly polarized antenna. From this RF signal block, so we are amplifying the signal. So as we are receiving from very large height, that is 20,000 kilometers, so we have to amplify the signal. For that we are using low noise amplifier in the GPS receiver. Low noise amplifier. From this low noise amplifier, again we are getting downlink converter. Whatever signal we are receiving, we are amplifying that and we are converting into downlink. The signal which we are getting of about megahertz signal, that would be the gigahertz signal. So we want only particular band frequency, that is the intermediate band frequency, that is IF frequency. So we are amplifying that signal, IF amplifier. amplifier. So whatever this IF amplifier signal we are getting, we are sending it to the main block where mathematical calculations will be done. So the signal which we will send to ADC converter, that is analog signal will be converted into digital signal. So again in this ADC we have amplifier will take samples of particular signal and we will quantize that signal. So sampling process and quantizer process will be done in the ADC process. Then digital signal will be sent to DSP process where we will calculate the mathematical calculations, calculate the expressions. So this DSP processor again will communicate with the microcontroller. Microcontroller will communicate with the display unit to display the height or latitude or longitude. So here again repeating, the signal will be received at RF signal, then that signal will be amplified at Lohner's amplifier, then we will convert the signal into downlink converter using downlink converter, and in the IF amplifier we will only filter the signal which we want, that is intermediate frequency signal. We will modify all the signal, we will remove the signal, only the signal band where we want to process the application. So we are taking only IF amplifier. So from the IF amplifier we are sending that signal to ADC converter, so where analog signal will be converted into digital signal. On that particular digital signal we are calculating our operations, DSP operations, and DSP would be this digital signal processor block will be in contact with the microcontroller. Microcontroller will display the latitude, longitude value, time value, height of particular GPS device from the mean sea level and the speed. So where we are decrypting this L1 and L2. So L1 and L2 is decrypted at this particular DSP level. So if L1 is directly decrypted, if it is a general public DSP receiver, if we want to get the precise location, then Y code should be provided. Y code should be provided for the particular DSP. Then using the Y code decryption, then it will also decrypt the L2 signal. If it is general public, then it will decrypt the L1 signal. For military purpose, if we give the Y code, then it will also decrypt the L2 code. Okay, then it will display here. So in the particular display, what we are getting at first point 19.23, 17.02. So this is the latitude, longitude value and height 502 feet from the above mean sea level. Then time would be 00 10 23 seconds with the date something 18 03 2020, and fourth what you are expecting, that is 60 kilometers per hour. These four will be displayed in the display. Okay, thank you.